guys, Ralph here, True Power, Trumpet Fitness. Let's get to it. I'm really, really rushed today. Crazy, crazy day. My cleaning lady's going to be in there, may walk in on us in this video for all I know. But anyway, I'm not playing yet today. So let's see what we got and talk a little bit more about Miles. A lot of questions and little anecdotes and whatnot. So anyway, let's get to it. Yeah, the chops feel really fresh this morning. I played a lot yesterday. And as long as that playing is done in a controlled manner and I can keep with the protocol, and I'm not on a job where I have to play higher and my chops aren't ready for it and I get beat up a little, as long as I stay with it, the more I play, the better my chops feel. And, man, this is going to be a good day. I will get to some practice later. Anyway, Miles, interesting. A lot of thoughts, a lot of stories, a lot of questions and whatnot. And as you know, I'm going to reiterate, I am not a Miles guy. I am not a jazz guy. I'm not a jazz expert. I have very, very little to give in that regard. And, for that reason, probably, I am not a big Miles fan. There's more to Miles than meets the eye, meets the ear, I should say. The eye is pretty well self-explanatory. And I guess that leads me to my first question. Several people, I don't know, 8 or 10 people, asked me, "What's up, Ralph? You're going easy on him about his chops. Crack notes, fuzzy tone, and you're letting it all go?" Yeah. And the reason is, as I said, and this is hard to explain, because quite frankly, I'm not a jazz guy. And maybe in this regard, I don't really know what I'm talking about. All right. But he is, and that goes back to our video also. Can you be a virtuosi? Without great chops. And in this case, I am not going to call him a virtuosi in the traditional way. He doesn't have Andre's technique. He doesn't have Maynard's chops. He just doesn't. He is not, in traditional way, a great trumpet player. He's a jazz icon. He's a jazz genius. But that does not seep over into his trumpet playing. It just doesn't. He was limited by the chops. And I ended the last one saying, just think, if he had an easy access to a double C, think of the things that he could have done. And that is what limits him, okay, in the virtuosi status, in my opinion. Some of you guys have other opinions. Let me know. Great, great jazz mind, jazz genius, jazz innovator, jazz groundbreaker, jazz icon. When you say jazz, Miles, I mean, that's the first word that comes to your mind a lot of times, especially if you're a trumpet player. Saxophone player would be Bird, but you don't get what I'm saying. But the control of the trumpet, the actual art of the virtuosity was not great, in my opinion. Okay, now, why did I let that go? Because, as I said, there's more to him than that. There's more to him than that. I can't get in his mind. Who would want to, right? And we don't know, is that the sound that he had in his mind? He was trying to break ground. He was trying for something cool, all right? And is that the sound that he was after? Or was it subpar chops that led to the cracked notes and the fuzzy tone? I think it's a little both. I really do. And I think, as I said, I think his original setup was actually quite good. Okay? But in his effort to do different things, it got screwed up. It really did. There's no question. Marks on his lip and the tone and whatnot. And certainly towards the end, he was a shell of himself. So again, that's why I gave him a break with the chops. Okay? Now, am I saying it better today? I hope so. I don't think his chops were great in any way, shape, or form. But he was a jazz icon. And that's where I gave him the benefit of the doubt on the first one. Okay? Does that clear it up? Okay. Another excellent question came from a couple people. And they said, what in the world did Vacchiano teach him at Juilliard? Excellent question. He wasn't going over Mahler and Strauss and Stravinsky and getting the right phrasing and Petrushka. So, I mean, he wasn't doing that at all. What he did was, and Miles loved it, the Arban book in every key imaginable. And Miles ate it up. Every note of the Arban book in every key imaginable. And Vicchiano used to, it was all a mind game. It was a computer, okay, that he was trying to get. And he used to say things, you know, you have, you know, a characteristic study up there. Number six, for the sake of argument. Right, in the key of F. Okay, you're in trumpet in E, and you've got a D trumpet in your hand. One, two, ready, go. But, I mean, this is the type of stuff that he did. Just mental gymnastics. Trumpet in E. If it's trumpet in E, and you've got a D trumpet, then you are playing trumpet in C. You're up a step for anybody who's counting. But you say, you know, trumpet in E flat, and you've got a B flat in your hand. Boom, boom, boom. Okay? Trumpet, and you've got an E flat trumpet in you. I mean, crazy, crazy stuff, okay? And, and that's the type of stuff he did. It was basically just Arban and etudes in every key imaginable. Now, again, he wasn't with him for a long time. It was, I believe, a little over a year. And that was that. Another couple stories, very interesting. And a couple guys chimed in that he was a good friend of Harry James. Interesting. Very interesting. I can't, the little bit I know about their personalities, I can't put them together. They played completely different styles of music. Maybe it was a couple trumpet junkies, you know? Anyway, they're very, very good friends. And the lore has it, this is not lore, this is a fact. Yes, this is a fact, because Harry told this story in a book written. And he said when he was playing with a small combo one night, Miles came in and listened to a set. And check this out. How cool is this? Harry does the whole set like he's Miles Davis. He's got the trumpet pointed towards the floor, okay? In very, very fuzzy tone and all that style, that the bebop and the cool style and everything. Think about that. And I guess it was quite good. And Miles loved it, and, the rest is history. But isn't that interesting that those two paths should meet in a mutual admiration society? You know, you can see Miles and Bird, but Miles and Harry? That's a match made in... I don't know where that match is made in. Maybe at a brothel. That's where the match is made. I don't know. But anyway, so that's that. And I got to get going. Any minute now, my cleaning lady is going to walk in here, and I got to get out of Dodge. So any comments and thoughts on Miles, please put them down. The email is fine if you don't want to put your name out there. But when you're just commenting on it, a lot of people like to read the comments. Not everybody does. So if you feel like doing that, fine. And again, if you want an answer for something about a lesson, and the lessons are going great, guys. Oh, I'm so thrilled with the lessons. And the 1SS mouthpiece is off the charts. It's revolutionizing trumpet, and it's gaining momentum, and you guys are in on the ground floor. Okay, so that's that, and I will see you tomorrow with something else. Thick in the tongue. press down the bottom lip, and spit buzz. Love you all. Have a great day, and live your life with true power.